The second and final dirt track race of the 2016 HARC Can-Am Series season is in Granby, Quebec. A quick half-miler. We're going to have cautions for this one. It's big enough for them to line up safely. Zayden Davidson, the Aussie, started on the inside pole position. Brandon Krasta started on the outside, and it looks like it's going to be Davidson with the early lead here. Mark Nutt trying to slip into second in that 50 car. No, takes a look down low on the number 9. And he's going for the lead as we head off into lap number 2. Skyla Johnson's been in the wall already, back in turn number 3 again, down in turn number 1, pushed up 4 wide with the other drivers such as Little John, Irvine, and Obrovac, still 3 wide. Couple of rows of 3 wide racing back here. Little John escapes free out of that rat's nest. It's Irvine stuck in the middle though, along with the points leader Wisnowski in the 41. Back in the battle for around 10th place, and they're still 3 and 4 wide. Reddington forces it into the, I guess that's the second middle line there in the 99, alongside the other 99 of Matt Duncan there in the black and blue car. Now the 99 dips to the middle to try and get that spot back, starting just barely to get at least a tiny bit more spread out, at least in a sane manner. Skyla Johnson really falling towards the back. Not sure whether they kept the setup that they did from qualifying and that's not working out during the race or what's going on, but that's got to be the third or fourth time that she has been in the wall. Gavin Moore's nearly gone around back behind them. I believe it was Nelson that nearly went around on the back straightaway. These guys are constantly making contact, but so far we're clean and green here up through the back half of the field. Back up front, it's Nicholson now in second place, having left Zayden Davidson in his dust. Elba Wanderley's up to third in the 16 car, showing what she's learned over the past four and a bit races of the campaign. She was sitting in third, gets pushed out of that by Michael Kane in the 75. Did not expect to see him up in the campaign ever, really, but especially not on a track like this. Perhaps maybe like a super speedway or something, but definitely not on one of these technical dirt ovals such as this. But Michael Kane looking like he has a strong car today. Just got to keep that thing out of trouble, which a few years ago he had a lot more trouble than he did now, but it should be interesting to keep up with him as he goes on his quest towards the front. Carl Andumian sitting in 11th in the one car. He's doing pretty well in points. A good run here could put him back up contending for the championship. Demir trying to get at the inside of him there, makes a little bit of contact, and Andumian hard into the wall there, gets airborne for a second look out. Nelson slams into the side of Andumian. Nelson with a ton of damage. That's last week's winner, likely out of the race. Doan gets a piece of that as well as everyone tries to get themselves back in their proper order of course here. John King, seriously, man, you gotta get out of Andumian's way. Well, that's a thing. That's the race leader that just got a significant piece of damage by, really, there's no other way to put that, Arca braking into the back half of the field. I mean, they really should have got going faster than that, but Nutt also has to be careful where he's going, and from a veteran I expect a little bit better than that. Nutt's certainly going to pay the biggest price for that. I believe Nicholson and Kane might have also gotten a small pieces from that as they stacked him up in there. They had a little bit more of an excuse. Nutt had open air in front of him. He could generally, I mean, there might have been a little bit of smoke from Andumian's wreck, but Nutt should have been able to see where he's going. Nicholson and Kane a bit more of an excuse there, and they end up carrying on. Nicholson's going to be the new race leader, it appears. Waiting for the restart, and we get it as we're halfway through turn 3 and 4. Very early restart, actually, by the starter there. Nicholson gets a good jump on Michael Kane. Zayden Davidson going after second spot, only one car out of the race from that previous incident. That was Ellie Nelson in the 96 who clobbered Carl Andumian. Surprisingly, Andumian will carry on, as will Mark Nutt, although Nutt is currently running in 39th place. Ton of work for him to do if he's to get back to the lead. And with a messed up race car, I just can't see it happening. Bill Littlejohn in the 30, showing his stuff early on here, trying to get past Michael Caine to get into a podium spot. Sikuli up into 5th spot, passing Elba Wanderley in the 16. As Santa Coors, the Dutch driver driving the McDonald's number 82, makes her way past Demir Bejianov. Bejianov won a short track race back in 2015. Would not be surprised to see him do well at another half miler such as this, even with the different surface. Alex Wheeler currently alongside the 13 Appleseed. Wow. That was a hell of a save by Johnny Appleseed in the double zero, who is all sorts of sideways, or should I say slideways, through turns 1 and 2. Somehow managed to carry that on without losing a spot. Very good job as he runs the absolute bottom, trying to get by Brandon Carasta here. Now it's Sikuli going after Bill Littlejohn for, I believe, that's third position. Kane's all over him. Once again, great racing all around this half-mile facility. Sitting in seventh currently, it's Henrietta Fitzwater, who has been consistent as hell these first few rounds of the season, currently maintaining an average finish of around, I think, 13th place, something like that. She's got a bit of damage from something. I imagine perhaps the stack-up incident that took Mark Nutt out of the race lead, potentially. But still sitting in the top 10, certainly, going for after another good run here today. Johnny Appleseed, up from 30th spot. I think we're only around 20 laps in, yet he is up to 8th, just powering his way through the field on the opening laps. Jim Mack is sitting around 17th place. Santa Coors just got up into the wall out of turn number 4. Ran that thing a little bit too hard. Jim Mack sliding up the track a little bit. Alex Tanker gets into him. And Mack goes down into the inside wall, now into the pit wall. He will get that thing slowed down and immediately go to his pit stall. Probably a good idea to try and repair some of that damage, but that's certainly going to take him out of contention for a good run here today. Really unfortunate. Kind of an aggressive move by Alex Tanker off of turn number 2. Really unnecessary considering how early on we are into this race. Santa Coors also nearly got turned into that inside wall by Sawyer Girl. Some pretty intense racing. These guys got to cool it down or else we're going to see some more cautions here in the not too distant future. Santa Coors will get away with that one. Now going after Bejianov for, I want to say, some around 15th. Probably a little bit further back, but hard to say exactly. DJ Harris is back here as well, trying to get up towards where his teammate Alex Wheeler is. Wheeler's been having a good run so far this race. Harris did not qualify so well in the 36. Oh, that's Obrovac back there that got turned around on the back straightaway. And that's several cars around. That's the 88 of Lesavage, nearly put on his lid by Gerald Reddington, the 99. He will continue on. I imagine he's going to have to pit that 88 car, as well as perhaps Reddington's probably going to have to pit as well. Obrovac was sitting 22nd, let up the gas just a little bit to stay off of the 01, gets run into the button by the 99, just a quick bump and run, no big deal, but Benoit Lothair Irvine got into the 3, and that would result in the 8, the 88, and the 99 getting caught up in that mess. Everybody else manages to get away, and I don't think we're going to have another stack-up mess. Didn't hold up enough people for that, and hopefully these guys will be a little bit more smarter about it this time. Carlin Dumian narrowly avoids not going a lap down there. Pace car on pit road, and Nicholson back, brings him back to the green once again here in the 43 machine. Lucas Knight went a lap down from pitting on that last caution due to the damage of the last accident. Jim Mack, who appears to be in second right now, is actually 2 laps down. Carlin Dumian was already a lap down, actually was about to be lapped a second time, so a bit of a correction from just before the caution. And Matt Duncan actually fell out of the race underneath the caution flag. Due to a blown engine, Team Thunder engine reliability strikes again, as that's the points leader in the wall back there. We're under caution once again. Stringer a little bit slow on the restart there, gets turned around by Krasta. Aiden Shepherd damn near gets turned into the outside wall from that, manages to save it, nice job. Stringer gets that thing slowed down, very light contact with the pit wall, and he will get back onto the racing surface just fine. A little bit of right side damage, but no big deal overall. Bigger than the incident that triggered the caution in the first place was what happened on the cooldown lap as Shelley turns Wisnowski into the outside wall. It's unclear to me whether or not that was premeditated or whether that was just an accident. It didn't seem like anything was really happening between those two at the time other than they were racing close together, but Shelley was certainly holding Wisnowski down to the wall pretty hard there. Under caution, Matthew Nicholson blows a motor under caution here, and that's the second leader of this race that has gone out of the race under caution. Really strange how this race is developing. Actually, Nicholson had been running away with it on the green flag stints, as had Nutt before his retirement, so it should be interesting to see who takes over the race lead once we get back to the green flag. I believe it's going to be Davidson with the race lead when we go back. Actually, it's going to be Joshua Sekulli here in the 07 that's going to take the lead on the restart. Jim Mack here with a prime opportunity to get one of his laps back from these leaders if a caution is to come out relatively shortly. Johnny Appleseed, what a power move down into turn one. He's gone from 30th to the lead in less than 50 laps. Very, very impressive by the 00. I would not be surprised to see him pull away with this thing a little bit with how he's been running so far. Davidson gets shoved up wide after near contact with Little John. Little John back onto the podium. That's Joshua Sekulli into Appleseed. Nice bump and run by the 07. Here comes the 30 up the inside as we're back under yellow. That was why that was so aggressive there. What a very aggressive move by Sekulli into turn number 3. Wasn't quite sure why. That seemed like something you'd pull on in the final few laps. But considering the caution was out, it all kind of makes sense now. Brandon Krasta trying to make the high line work against Ryder Smith in the 70. He gets off the throttle a little bit, but gets into the wall nonetheless. And the 69 gets into the back of him. And Krasta goes around Johnson with nowhere to go in the 29. That might take her right out of the race. Skyla's been getting into incidents, not necessarily of her own doing, kind of all season long. Has not had the best luck. Not sitting at the tail as far as at the extreme tail end of the field as far as points, but the season's still not going as well as her nor her team owner Jeffrey Fingai I'm sure hoped. Irvine narrowly avoids the spinning car of Craston on the way back to the flag. Martinez gets into the rear of the 15, and Irvine takes a very, very hard hit into the ambulance gate. Kind of ironic how that happened. Irvine, though, certainly with one of the hardest hits of the year so far. Hope that he is okay after that one. Under caution, and it seems like the drivers are having a little bit of miscommunication here as to who's going where. Big stack up here, holding the back half of the field up here as drivers struggle to get into their proper places. It's going to be interesting to see whether or not they're going to leave the caution out longer to get this sorted out, or what they're going to do here. Luke Obrovac's blown an engine. That's not going to help things at all back here. Obrovac goes out of the race around halfway through. By the time that midfield finally got themselves sorted out, the leaders had already actually lapped them under caution here. Appleseed gets turned around from second. They're going to add a lap of caution or two to try and help these guys get it sorted out, but they've got to do that relatively soon, and now they're intermingling with some of the leaders, so they got to get themselves sorted out. I mean, they've been given clear instructions by the HARC officials on what to do here and how to line up, but they don't really seem to be doing it, and I think the lights are going to go out on the pace car next time by. They're just fed up with waiting for them, and I guess a few drivers are going to go a lap down as a result, but it's kind of their own fault here, so we're going to see what happens. Pace car back in, and, well, that's a thing. The 88 is going to go a lap down, it appears, as will the 8, who's already a lap down. Most of these drivers that were stuck and don't seem to be able to get themselves back in line were already damaged anyways, so I guess that's not that big of a deal. They weren't following HARC instructions as to where to line up, and as a result, they are going to go another lap down, or at least one lap down. Because of it, they got to get this race back to green flag conditions. It's Sekouli back with the lead on the restart. He's got a bit of damage. I wouldn't be surprised if that was from the lap cars, and, well, that's not a surprise. That's not a surprise at all. We're back under yellow again. Lucas Knight pathetically slow on the restart. Matthew Stringer getting a little bit fed up with it here, although he's already a lap down as well. A little bit of frustrations boil over, and, well, I'm not surprised, and I'm not angry, just disappointed at that. Kind of... Well, let's see if they can get them lined up a little bit quicker than they did last time. This time, they seem to figure out where to go, and I gotta say, I never thought that I'd be impressed by something this small from a group of racing drivers in my life, but I'm glad they did it. I'm glad they were able to get in a straight line. That was real great. Next thing you know, maybe they'll learn to tie their shoes. But anyways, Sekouli is... leads the field back to the green flag once again with that slightly damaged race car. Michael Caine immediately drives back by the double zero and into second. Please don't tell me we're under caution. God damn it. Real? Are you? You're dead serious. You had... Well, at least no one's damaged that much. Let's see what happened. We couldn't even make it to the green flag on that restart before crashing again, as Fullerton was all over Gavin Moore. I know Gavin was a little bit slow, but again, we're only 50 laps in. Could have been a little bit more patient there. Moore pays the price there. He's spewing oil all over the place. Come on, really? Don't go to the racing line, you pleb. Get down pit road so we can get back to green faster, so we can have another wreck and restart again. Welcome to lap 60, as Sekouli's gonna get the restart. I believe this is gonna be the fifth restart, something like that. Who even cares anymore? Sekouli gets that thing back going, and Michael Caine is going after the race lead. It's been that sort of race, really, so far. Hoping things get a little bit better as we go on here. Maybe we'll get into a green flag stretch. Maybe we'll be back under yellow just as quickly as last time. But Sekouli holds on to the race lead for now. Zayden Davidson drives by Little John for fourth. That's Lily Gordon into sixth place, fifth, something like that. In the 83 machine, doing well. The Canadian driver. No idea where this driver's from. Canada's a big country, but apparently that's all the information we have on that driver. So, you know what? Fair enough. That's a thing. Annie Thomas in the 93, trying to make up some spots. I believe that Thomas is the biggest mover so far this race. She started in the 30s. Either her or Appleseed are certainly the biggest movers of the race, I do believe. The leaders starting to encounter some lap traffic, mostly just in the form of Lucas Knight in the 8 car. That's a bit depressing that he's running that slow. It's only been like 15 laps since the restart, and already the 8 going a lap down, nearly a second slower than the leaders. are at this moment in time, just trying to hold on. He's been fairly gracious as a back marker, though, so I mean, A+. Gold star to you, sir. Sawyer Girl and Santa Coors gonna try and split the 8 car. Nope, Sawyer Girl just pretty much flat out dumps the 8 there. Came up on him rather fast, and Girl gets into him once again as the 8 tries to recover from that. Both drivers onto pit road. No, the 8's gonna decide to nope out of pit lane actually there. Sawyer Girl's gonna get some repairs to that car, and the 8 will continue on. Well, that's unfortunate. That kind of sucks, actually, because it's probably just going to happen in another 20 laps when we go back to green. But, you know, Oh, no, the 8's coming down pit road. Might go out of the race. Who knows? That might be a thing. We're going to have 49 laps to go when we get the green flag here. Pace car in once again. The flagman has been waving it fairly early so far. Finally waves it now a little bit later than normal, as Sekouli dives it off into the corner. Kane looking up the inside though, and Kane may get the race lead at some point. Demir Bejanov went out of the race around 20 laps ago, probably during that whole caution fiasco. Could be from Terminal 69 engine cancer, I don't know. Same with Karl Andumian in the One Machine, and recently, good news, Lucas Knight out of the race in that 8 car will not pose a threat to the other drivers. Rather, the other drivers won't pose a threat to him. He wasn't doing that bad as a lap car. It's just, I'm not sure what's going on with what was going on with the drivers today, but not sure whether everyone ate a little bit too, like, got a little bit too much of a dose of bath salts from their the cornflakes or what, but hoping this thing will just go a little bit smoother from here on to the end. Kane really breaking away from Sekouli, actually. This could be Kane's day. The 80-something-year-old British actor looking to finally claim his first career victory. He's been in the series since 2014 with no luck, but, well, he's not going to get away with it that easy. Pace car back out. We're under caution. The 87 of Stringer has been generally on pace despite the damage. He's a little bit slower in the corners than the others. Probably his steering isn't quite as great as it was at the start of the race, nor is, well, really anyone's. But Stringer gets sent around after Guerra gets quite impatient there. That's probably his second or third spin of the race. He will continue on yet again. He's been pretty pro at stopping that thing before getting too much damage, so I mean, I gotta give him credit for that. He has been saving it fairly well from his spins. It would just be nice to see him not spin again. That'd be great. 39 to go now. We're on lap 100. Kane gets the restart, and Sekouli already back a couple of car lengths from the 75. Looks like Michael Kane may run away with this yet again on the restart. Annie Thomas looking pretty good in the 93 car right now. The 01 up the inside into fifth place. I can't remember whether King was in the top five earlier on, but doing a fairly good job right now at least. Zane Davidson continuing to have a solid effort today, currently sitting inside the top 10, as is Alex Tanker. Still a little bit of controversy on turning someone into the inside wall earlier on in this race, but that was like six cautions ago, who cares? Santa Cruz in the 82 are trying to make up some positions. Again, in that McDonald's car, having a good run today, the Dutch driver. Elba Wanderley grinds along the wall for pretty much the entire turn 1 and 2. Not surprised at all, but still holding on to, I want to say, 16th or so, sitting behind Gerald Reddington, the 99, who is in the top half of the field, so he may gain some points in this one. I believe he was sitting 13th in points coming into this race. It'll be interesting to see where he is coming out of it. Shelley nearly gets into the wall there, and Reddington looks like he's going to make up a spot through that. Meanwhile, we're three wide for fifth place. Actually, Johnny Appleseed got shoved out of line by Bill Littlejohn. Littlejohn's in second or third as we speak, I believe, and Appleseed's been stuck on the outside ever since. Been trying to make that work, trying to get some of those positions back to no avail. The inside is the pretty much the only way to go at this course. You've just got to keep that car down there, and that's the ultimate struggle here. Probably should have mentioned that at the start of the race, but, you know, things happen. Just going to give a quick shout out to some of these drivers in the midfield who, you know, they might not necessarily have cars to fight for the top five, the podium, or the win, but they've been giving it all they got, and they've been keeping it generally green and clean the entire day so far. You guys are the real MVPs. Martinez, you're not really in that. You caused an accident. But Henrietta Fitzwater in the 61, definitely been keeping out of trouble so far this race. Tanker, sort of. So Littlejohn, though, has had nothing as far as getting into the top 10, but just based on brute consistency and staying out of trouble, she's going to get a good run here today. Currently sits, I believe, in the top 5 in points, and this is going to help her championship efforts. Daniel Voiles going after Zayden Davidson. Davidson up the racetrack. Voiles follows him there and gets sent down into the inside wall. Corrects that thing very, very well, actually. Keeping that thing pretty much pristine, and he will hold on to a top 10 with that, not even getting past. Well, now he will finally get passed by Santa Cruz, it does appear, but nice save there by the 52 and the 9 to keep this race going. Just 15 laps to go to perhaps Michael Caine's first career victory. He's starting to encounter a few lap cars. Just got by Mike Visnovsky. No problems there. You know, I'm actually surprised, but some of these lap cars have been actually rather kind when they can to these drivers. It's really a breath of fresh air considering everything else that's happened in this race. Bill Littlejohn currently sitting in second. Looks like he's going to become a bridesmaid yet again here. Sitting in second place, battling with it with John King in the 01. Some laps he's been closing in on Kane, other laps not so much. Still sitting more than a second back though, and with only 10 laps to go around now, he does not have much time to reel in Michael Kane. Martinez holding on to 20th. He's got a problem in the number 22. Look out, the 16 manages not to get into the back of him. Good job there. These drivers are learning, and that is good to see. But Martinez into the pits. He may go out of the race. He might just have a flat tire. I'm not sure what's going on with that 22 car. Perhaps, they're just replacing a tire on that number 22 machine. He's going to get back out there, but he's going to be a lap or two down. Perhaps a little bit of karma there for the one or two accidents that he helped cause in this race. Michael Caine continues with the race lead. Michael Caine comes off of turn number 3 and 4, and he's coming to the white flag with the race lead. Just one more lap to go before he could potentially get his first career HARC victory. Never thought I'd be saying that. Back in 2014, he was a bit of a laughingstock, consistently being chaotic, ending up in race accidents, causing race accidents, and just being a nuisance. Last year, he did not do too much notable. This year, though, he gets his first HARC victory in Granby, Quebec. John King finishes second in the 01 car. He drove by the 30 of Bill Littlejohn, left him in his dust, but had nothing for Kane in those final few laps. Littlejohn comes up with a podium in third place. Solid effort today. Sekouli led a lot of laps, actually led the most laps with 50, just one more than Kane led. And because of that, he will get two bonus points. Sekuli with that damaged race car, an impressive job, still finishing fourth. Annie Thomas started 10th and finishes 5th. Johnny Appleseed in the double zero will finish 6th. Ryder Smith, 7th. Daniel Voiles, 8th in the 52. Zayden Davidson started on the pole and will finish 9th. And Santa Coors, solid run today, just completing the top 10 with that 10th place finish.